My name's Sam from the YouTube channel Prep Medic, and in this video, I'm gonna show you how to apply a cat-style tourniquet to a severely bleeding extremity. Tourniquets are used for life-threatening bleeding from both the upper and lower extremities. Now, generally, the tourniquet will not result in permanent harm to that patient if they're applied for less than 4 hours. Under no circumstances should you remove a tourniquet once it has been applied to a patient. For application, this can be self-application or it can be applied to somebody else. In both those situations, the process remains similar. So when we're doing self-application with a cat-style tourniquet, I'm gonna take this, I'm going to feed my arm into it. Now, generally speaking, if I can see where the wound is, I should place the tourniquet 2 to 3 inches above it, trying to avoid joint capsules because that will result in injury to the patient and more severe pain than the tourniquet will already cause. If I can't see where the bleeding's coming from, whether there's too much blood or they have a long sleeve coat on, I can take this and I can put it high and tight on the arm. Proper staging is a must for self-application. Now, when I'm putting this on, I want to make sure this red tab is towards the heart. I'm going to take this and we're going to say that I don't know where the bleeding's coming from and go high and tight. And I'm going to tighten this down as much as possible without even turning the windlass. So I tighten that down and I'm going to take the strap all the way back, but let it hang before it gets to this bracket. I'm then going to take the windlass and I'm going to tighten it until all blood flow has stopped in the lower extremity. I'm going to take the tail of this tourniquet that I let drop a second ago. I'm going to feed it over, take the time strip, put it over, and then if you're in the mindset to do so, you can write the time of application to help the emergency room identify if it's safe to take off or if they need to provide medications to the patient prior to removing the tourniquet. The process for applying this to lower extremities in both buddy application and self-application is relatively the same. However, you may have to actually remove the end of the strap from the buckle to get it around a particularly large boot or to apply it to a leg while the person is trapped under a piece of machinery such as a motorcycle. If the first tourniquet applied to the patient fails to stop the bleeding completely, you can take a second tourniquet and put it on above the wound, either above this tourniquet or directly below it, and tighten that one down. If you don't have a second tourniquet, you can take the one that's already applied and attempt to turn the windlass a couple more times to stop that bleeding completely. For more medical how-tos, check out the other videos in this series. If you want to take a deeper dive into emergency medicine and EMS in general, check me out on my channel. I'm at Prep Medic on YouTube and I'm on Instagram.